Thanks very much. 3 minutes is not long, but still I can find out who is coming from Rwanda. Somebody from Rwanda here? Very good. I worked in the Rwandan prisons for 7 years, building biogas plants. I know you're suffering my accent. Yeah? Like I've done, also, you see, the biogas plants are structures we build underground to generate methane gas for cooking or for generation of electricity, but also can give you very good fertilizer for crop production or for forestation purposes. Let me go back a little bit. Like yesterday, we had a good party. We took kilos or tons of energy, and in less than a day, we get rid of that, just easily, forget about it. We flush it, we sink it in the ground, and sometimes you just see it float on the surface, and it's a health hazard. Now you're going to ask me, if you are so brilliant, and you are telling us something, what have you done? And this is what we're going to show you. The other question is, but where is this happening? It's happening in homes, in schools, in hospitals, in prisons, like I said, in Rwandan jails, Tanzanian jails, in the US jails, in European jails, for example. In Europe and America, you've done a lot, but maybe not sufficient in Africa, in Asia as well. So I would say that what our stomachs are really doing is not taking any energy. Otherwise, it would be really like balloons. We just treat, and our stomachs are just excellent processors so that we can recover sufficient energy for all our usage. Fuel, electricity, for example, organic fertilizer, you see. I say, Kuwait is too far for everybody. Angola is too far for everybody. Why don't we use the resource which is just created at the corner? So organic waste is really the ignored resources, in particular, the toilet waste. Okay? Yeah, this is a school where we have biogas plants to generate gas for cooking. This is a prison in Rwanda. Unfortunately, I'm not allowed to film the prisoners. Toilet waste also, you can see the way we just flush, get rid of it, sink it in the ground to pollute water, everything, soils. Yeah, you can see it's happening everywhere. You know all this. These are soakages we call in America. You can see sometimes we leave it on the surface and really just an environmental hazard. Now we are draining all this underground, nobody will see it, to generate gas. And we've created biogas systems that will serve not only Africa, but the rest of the world. And you will see, these are large systems ever built in Africa, including South Africa, but also in the world. So you can see prisons in Rwanda are cooking, you know, and they've replaced this kind amount of fuel. Remember the shelter we had party yesterday? All this would be covered with firewood. Can you imagine this kind of destruction of environment? So let us have the trees standing and grow. The fertilizer, you know, supports coffee, supports trees, and other crops. So you can see the three benefits: energy, sanitation, fertilizer. If you're not cooking on the gas, you can also make electricity, which everybody is very fond of. Power computers, but also support hospitals like this, you see? And very briefly, I would say that those who are not aware of the usage of this ignored resource, we go to a jail and say, this is a problem to you. Can you give it to us? So we take it to a hospital as long as the terrain allows, and we make electricity and we can save our hospitals. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.